Let's do in this lesson a side-by-side comparison of the three orders we looked at in terms of the integrated rate law. We looked first at first order, and then second order, and then zeroth order. So what we're going to do is just look at the plotting information, and we're just going to kind of draw them out and compare them side by side. Let's start with, I'll put them in order of numbers. Zeroth, first, and second. Down here we're going to do a plot in all three cases of what it would look like if it were a plot of concentration versus time. Okay? If it's zeroth order, it is a nice straight line already. And that is when the rate is a constant. Remember, it's zeroth order, so rate is just a constant. And you're going to have that nice linear graph. When it's first order, and we plot concentration versus time, we're going to get an exponential decay that looks something like this. All right, so this is first order, so rate is equal to k times a. Okay, raised to the first power. The rate, the change in concentration is not a linear relationship. But if we wanted to make it a linear relationship, we saw with the integrated rate law, which I'm going to write right here, that the natural log of a over a naught is equal to minus kt, okay? Or if it were in the slope-intercept form of a line, lost my a naught, natural log of a is equal to negative kt plus the natural log of a naught, okay? We see that in order to get a nice straight line between information about a and t, what we really have to plot is the natural log of the concentration of a versus time. Now this is going to give me a straight line, but the straight line is going to have a negative slope. The slope is equal to a negative k. All right, let's go on to the second order. If we were to plot the concentration versus time for this guy, we would also get a nonlinear relationship, but it drops off a little bit more rapidly. And then, if we were to want a linear relationship, what would we have to plot? Well, the integrated rate law is 1 over a is equal to kt plus the natural log of, sorry, I said natural log and I'm maybe crazy, okay, would be plus 1 over a naught, okay? So that's what we have for that equation. What this tells me is if I plot 1 over a versus time, I will get a straight line. But in this case, it is going to go in the up direction where the slope is equal to k. Okay, so we can obtain our rate constant from that graph. So in the integrated rate laws, we're comparing concentration and time, okay, but we are having those concentrations in different forms in order to get a nice straight line. So this is how this gets used. Typically, if it were a test question, we're not going to make you plot, okay? But we would say, okay, maybe leave off this graph over, this thing over here, and say, what needs to be plotted in order to have this graph? If it's a straight line, what did you plot? If it's a straight line, what's the order? Okay, if it's first order, what did you plot? Or if you plotted this, it's first order. We're going to be asking that kind of information of you with this. If we say, all right, a plot of natural log of a versus t gave a straight line, the slope of that line is a negative 30 1 over seconds as its units, and we say, what's the k? Well, you know the k is the opposite of its slope. So you'll be able to pull this information if we hand it to you on a silver platter. You might, for homework, or for the lab have to do the actual work of plotting it out. So you might be given data like this and say, all right, now I want you to go and determine what is the order. So what would you do? Well, the first thing I would do is use Excel. I don't want to get out graph paper and label axes because that's kind of a pain in the rear end. I would want to get at Excel, and I would make these two columns in my Excel spreadsheet, and then I would tell it to do a scatter plot, and I'd say, is that a linear graph? There is a correlation value you can get at, and the closer it is to one, the more linear it is. If that's not a straight line, I say, okay, let's take all of those concentrations and turn them into natural log of concentrations. So with a couple keystrokes, I will convert in Excel, I'll convert all of those concentrations to natural log of concentrations, and then I'll tell it to plot that. Is that a straight line? If this one wasn't, we know it's not zeroth order. If this one's not, then we know it's not first order. And then we could try the last one, which is to say, okay, let's plot 1 over concentration. So we'll turn all of those concentrations into 1 over concentrations and do a plot about those and say, is that a straight line? And if that is a straight line, aha, we have discovered it's second order. If it's not a straight line, we've just discovered it's not second order. So you can't go beyond. You can only know, is it zero, first, or second by which one of these is going to give you a straight line.